Ladies and gentlemen, again, this fight is for your Strikehard 145-pound title. In the blue corner, with a record of 5 wins and 3 losses, he stands at 5'11". His weight is 145 pounds, and he trains with Bad Company MMA out of Pensacola, Florida. Please welcome Michael Peltier. And in the red corner, his record is 8 wins and 1 loss. His height is 5'10", and his weight is 145 pounds. He trains with Spartan Fitness SBG out of Birmingham, Alabama. Please make welcome your reigning champion, David Danger Dave Clark. This fight is set for 3 rounds, and your referee is Cody East.
So these are two very large 145ers. And earlier when we were kind of setting up, I watched David Clark in the ring getting his little warm-ups in. His warm-up was most people's workout. Like, he was drenched in sweat. And it appears that he's one of those guys that tries to get a couple rounds in the locker room before he comes out to the cage.
Man, I tell you, he's a phenomenal athlete. The one thing that I would say about Michael is that the only thing that has been his downfall in his fights, he's been in every single fight, win or lose, but it's been his cardio. And I talked to him yesterday, and he said, man, I've been really working on my cardio, and you're going to see me go full blast all 3 rounds. So I'm really excited about this matchup. I tell you, man, there was no filling out process with this one.
Okay. Michael Peltier is kind of, he's on his heels. He's downloading information. Yeah, what he's doing, he's just kind of watching movements. And you know what? He just came with a, he's now starting to land. All that like initial exchange was just a feeling out period. Now David Clark is about to start going on the offense because he's looking at his openings. He's seeing the movements and where he can land.
Here's the thing that I'm not liking, man. Michael's left hand, he's dropping his left hand on them inside leg kicks, and that counters there every time.
Yeah, if you look at the concentration, look at Peltier's eyes.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he is super focused.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Well, he just slipped a hard right hand and countered. He didn't get the Peltier didn't get the power on the counter after slipping that right hand. But that's something that he's going to have to capitalize on. When you slip a big punch like that, you gotta make that person pay the tax associated with the miss.
Peltier has landed some solid shots right now on David
Clark. Peltier is getting the movement. He's got Michael Clark's, or he's got David Clark's movement down, and he's just working on his timing right now.
I mean, Clark needs to do something to disrupt what Peltier is doing. He needs to be more offensive. He's getting in front of him. He's not doing much with it. He's there. He's like, I'm here. I'm in position, but I'm not throwing anything afterwards.
What Clark is going to have to do is he's going to have to break the cadence.
Exactly.
Because the entire cadence rhythm of this dance right now is tilted towards Michael Peltier.
The fight happens when Peltier wants it. That's the only time that the exchanges are happening. You know, he decides it to happen. That's the problem right now for Clark.
Yeah. Yep. And if I'm Clark, it means I'm backing up. I'm doing something different. And maybe catching Peltier stepping forward. I'm going to do something to kind of disrupt the entire cadence of the rhythm of the fight that's taking place right now.
Right.
It almost just seems right now like the movement of Peltier and just kind of the erratic, just unconventional movement is really throwing Clark off. He's looking for a time to set up, and it's not there,
It's the footwork.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I mean, it's just kind of, it's not normal. It's side to side. It's left. It's right. It's not in front of you the whole time. It's a good job.
If you look, like, when they start to kind of get a little closer together, if you look at Peltier's feet, he's taking baby steps.
Yeah, a lot of little steps.
He's like when you see or hear like somebody throw a double jab. Yeah. What he's doing with his right and left foot, he's doubling up on his steps. Yeah. And what David Clark's going to have to do, he's going to have to disrupt that.
There was a good right hand shown in our replay. Yeah. They'll probably show another.
Yeah. If you watch the foot
good knee
work on Peltier, everything is coming from his feet.
Yeah. So
now, if you're David Clark, how about you might not be a wrestler. How about you come in for a shot, and then you come up with a big right hand?
True.
You know? Or, you don't even come in. You're coming in with a shot, but it's just – you're going to have to disrupt that footwork to where Peltier is starting to question himself about where he is.
You know, one thing we've talked about a lot is this, you have to be getting off first a lot of these times. Whoever's going to get off first is going to win. So Clark's just reacted. He needs to get off first and disrupt what Peltier is doing.
And you know what, Chris? What about pushing up against the fence?
That's a beautiful idea.
What about a clinch?
Slow him down a little bit. Get him in there, throw some knees, kind of slow him down a little bit. That'd be a great idea. He's got to do something just a little bit different. 100%. Standing out in front,
it's not
being second, is not going to work.
No. What he's done is he's got an opponent that knows his movement, has watched obviously a ton of tape on David Clark, and he's taking advantage of things that he already knows about.
Well, and also peppering that inside leg kick right there, that starts taking effect as the fight goes on, and especially them three or four body kicks that he had too as well, man. That'll start wearing on you after a while.
I agree.
That is one thing that, you know, a difference in between the professional ranks and the amateur. You got three-minute rounds compared to 3 5-minute rounds. Trust me, those extra 6 minutes are long when you're getting kicked in the leg.
So if you look at Peltier, he's...
He's tearing up the inside.
Well, it's a stutter step. He's stutter stepping to one side or the other, and then he's coming in at a different angle that Clark is having issues with.
Clark's really stepping up his power right now. He's throwing punches with bad intentions and kicks.
Yeah, you can tell Clark is one of those guys that's a workhorse. Like he's first guy in the gym and probably the last to leave.
Well, he's got to utilize that now. He better come in and throw. He's got to really do what he can to change the tempo, change the pace of this fight. He needs to do that by. There's different ways you can throw more volume, or he can throw more power.
What you're going to notice too is when David Clark commits to a right hand, you're going to notice Peltier just kind of leaning a little bit back on his back foot, and he's following the fist back and countering with a heavy punch right after. Yep. It's not like a big like movement out of his head. It's just a slight little quarter inch out of the way, and he's following the fist back.
And that's another reason you don't throw one punch. That was a good right hand by Peltier, but you throw that big right hand, you come back with the left hook.
Or double up.
That's why I like to throw the 2-3-2, the big right hand, follow the left hook, another right hand. A lot of times it's not the first one that's going to land. It's the second, it's the third.
Yeah, and David Clark, you know, when beginning of this round, he found a little bit of success. And he's got to kind of figure that out. Like you said, maybe instead of a two-punch combination, go 3, 4, 5, even 6.
Just throw as many. As long as that guy's not firing back, you're winning that round, that exchange. But the problem is Peltier is throwing back the whole time.
He is. But I'm going to tell you, David's starting to find that right hand, too. He's landed a few times already in this round.
All right. So when Peltier is coming in with the exchange, you're going to notice his front leg, when he really commits to it, his foot is always staying on the inside of Clark. If Clark can move his foot to where Peltier's foot is on his outside, I'm willing to bet he'd probably land a little bit more. Those little stutter steps we're seeing out of Peltier is for positioning of feet, which creates the angle.
100%.
I got to keep breaking it down for the people at home, but it's creating the angles, you know, for you know, his connectivity.
But when you got somebody just standing there and is not having good footwork, it's easy to create that angle.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. You're stuck in mud while 100%. This guy's just running around you.
Yep. Yes.
And landing successfully, heavy.
Yeah, exactly. This is the best I've ever seen Peltier look, man.
Well, 100%. Peltier's watched a lot of tape. Without even talking to him, I can tell you, he is very well studied in regards to this. And there's probably not a lot of surprises he's going to see out of Clark, which Clark's corner is going to have to address.
The only thing I worry about with him is he's dropping that left hand. You know, he keeps dropping that left hand, so we'll see what happens in the third round.
You know, I found that to be a much closer round. I think I would still think I have to give it to Peltier.
Wow. I'll agree with you, Chris, 100% on that. So
you know what I'm talking about if I'm in David Clark's corner right now?
We got to start setting
some traps. You know, we got to look at the footwork. We got to see where it's at. Push him against the fence. You know, we got to do something a little bit different.
Mm. Yeah.
And David Clark's good in the clinch, too. Hey,
David Clark.
He's a beast on the ground.
He's
a beast everywhere, you know, so.
Like I said, he's had some good punches, some good kicks, but the volume is just not there for him as far as who's landing the most punches, who's landing the harder shots.
You know, the thing with David Clark is he's also got a Taekwondo background, and he really hasn't found the range in his kicks yet, which is kind of surprising. And, you know, when you talk about Taekwondo, the angles that are associated with that when applied properly to mixed martial arts gives the average fighter fits.
That's true. He might have a Taekwondo background, but he's not really adapting
that.
He's not utilizing that style. No, he's committed to something else. That's why he's not really utilizing it.
And 10 years ago, Chris, we always made fun of the Taekwondo guys.
Yeah.
But right
now,
it has a place. If you see where it's at in mixed martial arts right now, it absolutely has a place.
Yeah.
They dropped some ice on the floor there on the canvas.
You know, that's Peltier's corner again. Well, and that's
a veteran move.
It's a veteran move when you're
but you know what? Look at Peltier.
Your cornering's tired.
Like you said, he doesn't look tired to me.
No.
Like you talked about that cardio he addressed. He said, look, it's going to be a different fight. I agree with him. It has been. You know,
that was a good kick.
And this is kind of right here. Almost. David Clark definitely needs to come out and do something.
We had mentioned he needs to find a range for his kicks. And apparently that was probably what his corner may have told him.
That was a good right. Peltier landed a nice right just then.
Yeah, Clark is going to be a little bit frustrated.
He's not using any angles or footwork, man. And he usually, that's all what I've always been impressed with him about is his footwork and his angles. And he's just not using it.
You know, earlier, he had a full workout in that cage. I mean, he was just drenched with sweat.
You say he looks a little stagnant now, maybe because of it?
I mean, I don't know if he pushed it a little too hard because... Like, he was as sweaty then as he is right now.
He is.
Well, Mike, we talked about that when we saw him in here. You said, I wonder if that's going to be a problem in the fight, you know? So
he does look a step slow
That left hand. Peltier is landing punches right now that are affecting Clark like they weren't in the first two rounds. These two are going at it.
The teeth of the body right there, rear teeth.
Oh, beautiful.
David Clark is using his kicks.
Oh, that was a good right hand by David. Peltier ate it. He kept coming.
He's got to keep following up. He's got to pour it on right now.
You know, this game is about hammers and nails, and you can be a good hammer, but you also got to be a good nail. Both of these guys can take a punch. Yeah, David Clark's corner is screaming for volume. They want him more active.
Absolutely.
And you know what David Clark is trying to do? He's trying to counter. And it.
Well, at this point, if he wants to try and counter, he better come with bombs the whole time. Every counter better be extremely powerful because he has to do something different. I think he needs to be throwing hard punches and kicks coming at him.
Oh, shit, that was low.
A little low.
Fight.
I think he said, I don't need anything.
That was a quick break.
You know, one thing I've noticed, man, is Peltier is circling out to his left and throwing that three, and it's been landing all fight.
Peltier's got to keep his lead foot on the outside. He's got to keep it on the outside of David Clark.
Yeah. I mean, David Clark, when he's throwing a right hand, he's just like afterwards, he's like, okay, I threw it. He needs to stay on him the whole time. He backs away. You can't back away at this point. There's a time to do that.
Oh, that landed.
David Clark is now starting to kind of crack that code.
Yeah, but it's
just too late.
Too late, man. They're sliding.
And you know,
I mean,
David Peltier, you know what it is? He's kind of hit the wall cardio-wise. If you look at all the movements that we're talking about, the stutter steps and the angles and the movement, he's really, really worked hard to get this. You know, he's probably put in twice the work in terms of overall output is David Clark. And he hit a wall for about that last 30 seconds.
He did.
Yeah.
He did.
You know,
I tell you, man, Michael.
Very impressive performance.
Michael didn't tell any fibs to me yesterday, man. He said he worked on that cardio, and he sure did, man. He kept it going.
He looked phenomenal
with that.
I mean,
I agree.
Great fight right there. I would think, you know, I would probably give that last round to David Clark. But I think overall, I think you're going to have to give the fight to Peltier, I think.
Yeah, those body shots at the end of the round, they really took their toll. Really took their toll.
So Peltier just came up and showed us his foot, man.
Is it ugly?
It's not. It's ugly.
I mean, maybe it always is, though. We don't know.
Yeah, man, that's true. Oh, no, it kind of looked black and blue, man.
Oh, okay, never mind.
Oh, no, there's a huge welt. He may have broke a bone in his foot.
Nah, he's fine. He's being weak.
Maybe that's why David Clark was able to kind of connect
on the third
in that third round.
Yeah.
If you look at the foot, there was a giant welt on his foot.
Yeah, I say 29-28.
That's what I would get, but they're not even really giving the scores. They're just saying unanimous decision.
I know. That's one thing I think they should do.
Absolutely.
we're about to make this official. I think they're tailing it up right now.
You know what that means, Mike?
Yes.
Nonsense. You know who's got a workout today is the judges.
It's been entertaining.
Strikehard fans, your judges have come to a split decision. Your judges' scores are as follows. 29-28, blue. 28-29, red. And 29-28, blue, your new champion, Michael Peltier!
I agree with that. I agree with that. You know, if I'm...
You agree with the split decision? I definitely
don't.
I agree with the split decision. I agree with the winner. No.
Yeah, I think it was 29-28 as well.
We are joined here in the cage tonight with your new 145-pound... Man, how does it feel to have that belt around your waist?
Oh, man, it feels good. It's been a long road so far. Been fighting probably like 2 years now. It's my third title fight out of six fights, so finally... Got it. I'm good. Got my team here. My beautiful girlfriend. Normally, I got my son on my shoulders, but he's not here this weekend. Wish he was, but hey, glad to be here. Thanks for Andy for hitting me up, setting up the fight, you know, because we took this 3 weeks out. You know, the guy pulled out of the fight for Nick, and we came in. So here we are, ready to go.
Three rounds, man. You did your best to finish it off. It looks like you maybe did a little something to your foot. Man, what... How does it, man, to know that something's wrong and to keep pushing through? What mental toughness does it take?
I don't even know this is broken, man. I was in the Marine Corps, so it's just like warrior spirit. Keep pushing.
So standing in the cage door over here, that's Jacob Harrell right there. Jacob has two belts for two different promotions. He wants you. What do you say? As soon as that foot heals up, what do you say?
I say let's run it.
Be looking, Jacob Harrell, Michael Peltier, as soon as things go.
Hey, my thing is that if you're going to do the sport, you fight the best people around. If he's the next best person around, that's who I want to fight. That's it.
So what do you think?
Hey, let's get it, baby.
Give it up to your new champ. And the next fight is Strikehard in January.